On our pork butt, I like to debone it. There's a fat seam. Here's the bone. There's a fat seam that runs between the major muscle and then the minor muscle over here. I kind of open it up with my hands as much as I can, then I go in with my boning knife, separate it out just a little just to open it up. Whoop, hold on. You can get in there and just pull it apart with your fingers a lot of the way. You don't even need a knife. And you just follow right along that curve. Try not to cut into the muscle. Just follow the fat seam. You're going to butterfly it open. And I'd say this is at least an 8-pound pork butt. You've got to cook a minimum of 5 pounds. This is at least 8, maybe 9. It'll be obviously less when the bone comes out. Once you get down to this point, you're down to the bone. I usually come in there, follow the top of the bone, slide it down, just follow it right around like that. Here you've got to make a commitment. You've got to cut it either down the bone or here to expose the bone. I usually just follow right down that. There's a fat line that goes right there. I usually follow right down that fat line. Then we can open it up to expose the full side of the bone. And I just take short little cuts. Open it up, follow the bone. Get a sharp knife, don't cut yourself, take your time. Perfectly legal to cook them bone in if you want to. I just like to do this. It exposes more surface area so I can get better rub, penetration, and better flavor, in my opinion. We also cook our butts with a brine. We're going to inject it. Pretty simple recipe. It's just 2 quarts of water, 1/2 cup of kosher salt, 1/2 cup of sugar if you want to. Pump it in there, let it sit for about 8 hours, pull it out, wash it off, pat it dry, rub it, let it sit for a couple hours with rub on it, then we put it on. Just follow the bone. You can feel the bone with the knife. Don't hurry. You don't want to cut yourself. Try to outline the bone with the knife as much as you can. Sometimes you can get in behind it, stand it up, and you can feel the back side of the bone. Just try to keep your knife as close to the bone as you can and leave as little meat connected as possible. And like anything else, it takes practice. So that's pretty clean. Then we'll open it up a little more, continue to follow that fat line. So I can basically butterfly it into 2 pieces. When I cook it, I'll wrap it up like that. We can slice here, we can pull over here. I'll cut off some of this extra fat and silver skin off the top that we don't really need. Adds no flavor, obviously. And it's just extra stuff to have to cook. We want meat, not fat and silver skin. Come through here, take some off that flap. Alright, that's looking pretty good. That's what we call a deboned pork butt. Now we've deboned our pork butt, we're going to inject it. I like to just take them, put them right in the bag, that way it'll catch all the stuff. And there's not a technical art to this. You just pump it. I've got 2 quarts of water, a 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of kosher salt. Now I'm going to pump it in. What you want to do is just inject it in so that it stays inside the meat. We've got a lot of muscle tissue to work with here, so most of it will be injected when I'm done. And you'll be able to see the pork swell up when you get it pumped in there. All the fat seams will get full of the brine and it will be quite puffed up. use a slow motion. You don't have to try to jam it all in there at once. That way the muscle tissue has time to expand and accept the brine that you're shooting into it. Just want to take your time with it. And after I get that done, I also like to flip it over. I would inject that more, but that's just a demonstration. I like to get plenty of brine and get right inside that fat cap. There's a thick fat cap on the back of the pork butt. I like to get a nice, good layer of the brine and all those layers of fat. That way when it cooks down, it'll dissolve nice and baste that pork. Some people like to trim their fat caps. I don't do that. I like to leave it on there. That way if something gets burned, gets a little too hot, that fat cap will give us an extra little cushion of support. That's looking good now. All right, so you just pump it till it's in there. You let it sit for about 7 or 8 hours. Pull it out, very important. You pull it out, you rinse it, you pat it dry, then you put your rub on, otherwise it'll be a little too salty.